हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेकंड ईयर कॉमर्स क्लास। आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास, टुडे लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट स्टाफिंग एंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंस। इन एनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वेदर इट इज स्मॉल और लार्ज, स्टाफिंग प्लेस ए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। इफ यू हैव ए वेरी गुड एंड skilled staff in your organization, your management administration will be very easy and the success rate of your organization will be high. It is quite simple, ma'am. You can understand the role of employees, the role of staff. Staff is nothing but the employees of your organization. Staff are nothing but the employees of your organization. Whether they are AYA, junior lecturers, senior lecturers, clerks, accountants, any other experts who are contributing or rendering services for our organization will come under the staff. Okay, so you can compare these employees with the players of a team. Simply you observe as you watch cricket matches or football matches or hockey matches, where group of people have to perform. When the players perform well, automatically the team wins. That means captain is not much worried about the winning as long as he has got talented players in his team. Similarly, for any business organization, the management is not bothered about the result if it has got better staff. So try to understand that condition. If you have got good staff, so your future problems will be avoided and your success rate will increase. Okay, in business, okay, risk is inevitable. Changes may take place, uncertainties we have to face, but if you have a well-forced staff, all these problems you can overcome. So what exactly staffing is? Putting people to jobs. Means when you establish a business organization, as I said just few minutes back, you require various personnel. You require watchmen, you require security guards, you require accountants, you require clerks, you require supervisors, you require managers. If it is a college, you require teaching staff. According to the nature of the job, you require the people. So it starts, staffing starts at recruitment. Here all the steps I have written. Recruitment means give advertisement in the newspapers and various other medium of communication that you require so many people, receive the applications, conduct interviews. That is what called as recruitment process. Recruitment includes giving advertisement, calling people for interviews. That means receive the applications and conduct interviews. The second stage is selection. After conducting interviews, you have to select the right person. Then training, because sometimes people may not be knowing how to work in your organization and their qualification, their experience may not be on par with your standards, so you require to give some training so that you can make the employee acquainted with your system, familiar with your system. So you need to train, then develop them by providing training, by conducting various workshops, by guiding them. You develop their skills and you promote them. Once they are eligible for promotion, means you can elevate them to the higher positions. Compensation means give them reward, that means pay salaries according to their services. Then performance appraisal means try to assess what is the contribution of each employee, in what way they are working. This is very much important. If you take all the employees granted and if you assume that all employees are working in an equal manner, that may lead to dissatisfaction, because sometimes some employees will work with excellence, they contribute more, and some employees may not be working according to the directions of the organization and they may not be giving good results. So performance appraisal means every time, every year or periodically, the management has to assess which employee is working better, how far he is able to reach the targets. So in best, in what way can we can give him incentives? Like that, you have to know what the employee is doing, and if he is doing well, you have to appreciate his efforts. So that is what matters. So they are the steps of staffing. Now, in what way staffing is very important to the organization? First one, it helps in discovering and obtaining the competent personnel for various jobs. That is very much important. Just now I told you, competent personnel means best player in a team. What do you mean by competent person? Who has got the ability to perform, who has got required qualification, required experience, and ability to hard work. Okay, his attitude towards the organization is positive. So he wants to grow along with the organization. If you recruit such people, definitely they will contribute. How do you know they are competent or not? How come you know about their experience and qualification? This process in recruitment and selection, you will test the skills of employees, that means the aspirants. So that is the reason they conduct interviews. Even in future also, when you apply for jobs, you have to undergo at least 5 rounds of interview. Maybe 2 decades back, when population was less and the jobs were not so complicated, just people were given jobs based on their qualification. But today, companies don't require, they cannot recruit people just based on qualification. They require your skills. So sometimes even a person who is qualified, maybe having an academic record of 90%, but he may be lacking communication skills, he may be lacking practical knowledge. So to test those skills, so organizations, any business firm, according to the requirement of the job, they will conduct the interviews, written tests, group discussions, okay, interview with the technical expert, phone conversation, your body language, everything is tested, then you are given the jobs. So even you can speak to your siblings or your cousins, relatives, neighbors who are appearing for interviews in various MNCs in the recent times, you can know all these steps. So today securing job, even in private sector, is not an easy job. Government is highly saturated, very difficult. Still, if you try, you will get. But you need to perform well in the various written examinations to crack the job, either in the private sector and in the government sector. So business organizations, the management will conduct the recruitment process. So in that, we will select the right people. So these competent people will be taken for various jobs. So that means your job is half done. That means if a person is good, he is skilled, so automatically he can do the job, he can do the work, he can complete the task, whatever you assign. Next, it helps in achieving higher performance by putting right person on the right job. This is very much important. You have to match the employee. Suppose say when different positions are there, people do come. By conducting interviews, you try to know what are the various areas in which the employees are interested. If you give them the wrong field, wrong platform, they may not perform well. For example, if I am interested to teach accounts, if I am given commerce, so somewhere else it may discourage me, somewhere else it may demotivate me. So first of all, when you got different lecturers, suppose if I am teaching regularly teaching commerce, but sometimes if the management asks me to, sir, go for economics, means I may struggle. I may not be, say, giving my best because I am habituated and I am satisfied with my commerce. If my subject is changed, I may not be giving my best. That is a problem may arise if the people are mismatched for the job. So not only teaching, even in various business fields also, there are certain departments. So you have to identify the people in which department they would like to work. So accordingly you give them the positions. So naturally, when you keep a right person at the right place, ultimately the employees will give you the highest performance. Next, helps in continuous survival and growth of the enterprise What do you mean by survival? How come an organization will survive? Very simple. When it achieves its objectives, when it reaches its goal, when it tries to reach its goal and when it tries to perform well, it will survive. That means it will earn profits. So, staffing, by giving you good people, competent employees for their respective positions, as the employees will be working hard to achieve the goal of the organization, naturally, staffing will help you to survive and it will help you to grow in the market. Next. Staffing helps in optimum utilization of human resources. This is very much important. Many times, I think 50-100 times I might have told you about optimum utilization. Means use the thing to the saturation point. Whenever some resource is there, you have to use it like a sugar cane. I might have told you during first year classes that you observe any sugarcane juice vendor, you see how he extracts juice from the sugarcane till the last drop. Okay, he squeezes until the sugarcane becomes the dried pulp. Next time, if not today, till now you didn't observe, means next time when you go out, you observe the sugarcane vendor. Clear? Next, it improves job satisfaction and morale of employees through objective assessment and fair reward for their contribution. Means, how employee is satisfied? When his efforts are recognized, when his contribution is rewarded. So just now I told you that through performance appraisal, or you can say performance appraisal of job, the employee is informed about his contribution, how well he has done his job, what is his contribution in the success of the organization, what was the task given, to what extent he has completed. So if he is merited, he has got a meritorious advantage, he will be rewarded by giving some bonus, by giving some promotion. Okay, he is recognized. When the efforts and services of the employees are recognized, they feel satisfied. And you have to reciprocate them with proper remuneration, proper rewards. That's how staffing will improve the skills and morale of employees. So quite naturally, for the future, they will be working with great zeal to develop the organization further.